G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And this is just going to be the first video in a short series on taking readings using a automatic level and an e-face staff. So in this first video, I'm going to take you through pretty much step by step, show you how to take the readings and then how to record them in the level book. And then in the subsequent videos, I'll take away a bit of that information and you will actually have to take the videos yourself and just practice taking the readings, okay? So just to explain what you're looking at here on the left-hand side of your screen, I've got a representation of the view through an instrument. So you can see the staff there. And if I move the staff to side to side, you can see I've got the crosshairs. So you've got the main crosshair in the middle there. You've got stadia lines up, above and below. They're not going to be an issue for this video, but the main thing you need to concentrate on is that main crosshair. And then in the background there, you can see we've got the staff. So as long as you take all your readings off this center line, then you should be pretty accurate. Over on this side, I've got a bit of information. So where the actual tripod is positioned, the position you're taking the reading at, and in this case, it's the datum. So I've got an RRL and RL for the datum, and whether it's a back sight, an intermediate sight, or a foresight. And then here in the table, I've got the first three columns of your level book, and then the last column of your level book. Most of the times you'll have columns in between here, but they'll change depending on whether you're doing a rise and fall or a height of collimation level book. So this is just about taking the readings and filling out the reading information. So that's all we're going to look at. Okay, so this is our first reading. It's a back sight, back to the datum from the first position. So to take the reading, I always try and find the bottom of the E first. So in this case, that's going to be 700 millimeters or 0.7 meters. Every leg and every gap is worth 10, and the whole E is worth 50. So this is going to be 750. 760 millimeters. Okay, so it's a back sight. So it goes in this column in the first row, and we put a remark that that was reading was taken to the benchmark. Okay, so that's the first one. All right, then we go to the next reading. Okay, so you can see here we've gone up to 1.7. So 1.7 meters, and this is halfway between the 0 and the 10, so I would say that it's 1.705 meters, and it's an intermediate sight to our reading A. So it's going to go in the intermediate sight column on the next row down. So we put that in there, and we put some information in our remarks. That was to point A. Okay, next one. Give you guys a second to work out the reading. So 1 meter 50, 60, 70. It should be about 1 meter 70. Again, it's an intermediate sight, and it goes in the next row down, which will be for row B or reading B. Next reading. Okay, so this is still from the same position, reading C, but it's going to be a foresight. So this is going to be the first reading before we move the instrument. Okay, so it's going to go in the foresight column on the next row down. So 750, halfway between, so 755, we'll say. So 755 to position or reading C. Okay, so if that's a foresight, we're now going to move the tripod. So the next reading we take is from tripod position 2, and it's going to be a back sight back to our point C or reading C. Okay, so this case it's going to be 2.5, 25, 50, 60, 70, 80, 25, 90. So it's a back sight on row C. It's going to go on this row. Okay, so 25, 90. Okay, then we go to the next one, still at tripod position 2. reading D and an intermediate site. So we're going to get back into the intermediate site column. And our reading is going to be 1195. So we'll put that in the intermediate column on the next row down, 1195. Row D, or reading D. And the next one, still an intermediate site to position E, or reading E. So 1150.65. Okay, and then the last reading we're going to take will be a foresight. Let me change that. It's going to be a foresight to position F. Okay, and that's an even 900. So I'll just click on that. Okay, so it goes in the foresight column to position F. So there we go. We've taken our series of readings with one change point in it. We've recorded them into the level book. So now you can either use your hydrocollimation or rise and fall to work out what the RLs would be. In the next video, we'll do something similar, except I won't give you the actual position or where they go in the table.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.